Every Who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Now, please don't ask why, no one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight.
Grinch! Take that off!
I love green. I love green!
But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. And then they'd do something he least liked of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'd stand hand in hand, and the Whos would start singing. They'd sing and they'd sing, and they'd sing, sing, sing. Then he got an idea, an awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. The Grinch laughed in his throat, and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and coat. And he chuckled and he clucked.
What a Grinchy trick, with this coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick.
The Grinch looked around, but since reindeer are scarce, there was none to be found. Did that stop the old Grinch? No. The Grinch simply said,
Max!
On a ramshackle sleigh, and he hitched up old Max. And the sleigh started down towards the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in their town. And the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. When he came to the first little house on the square, then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders.
The Grinch had been caught by this tiny Who daughter, who gotten out of bed for a cup of cold water. The old Grinch was so smart and so slick, he thought up a lie, and he thought it up quick.
Why, my sweet little tot? There's a light on this tree that won't light on one side, so I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here.
3,000 feet up, on the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with the load to the tip-top and dumped it. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, the sound was merry. It couldn't be so. But it was merry, very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes. Then he shook.
Do not need presents for the Christmas?
With a shocking surprise.
What is Christmas about?
The tall and the small was singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling.
How could it be so? It came without ribbons, it came without tags, it came without packages, boxes, or bags. Maybe Christmas doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
Then, the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light. And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he...
Welcome.